Hello everyone, in this video, I want to show you on how to find extrema max or minimum values for combined associated indicators based on multiple columns with data modeling and DAX expressions. In my example desktop file, we have a matrix visual to describe the maximum, minimum, and average values of systolic indicator, diastolic indicator, and the pulse indicator according to slicer selection of this report page. To the maximum and minimum values of indicators, for example, the maximum of systolic. When we list the systolic max value, same time we need also append its associated max diastolic value as well. For this read, our calculation should first find out max value of systolic, then based on this max systolic to check out its associated max diastolic. To find out these extremums, we may have different approaches which depends on what data we already have in our existing data model schema. From our sample file in DataView, we see that in the factor table blood pressure list, we have those records of systolic, diastolic, and pulse with each record ID in different columns and stored in a crosstab table structure. As our designed matrix visual requires blood pressure indicator category in row to describe the three measures of maximum, minimum, and average in columns. Thus, to easy measure calculation, we may first to change in this data story structure from the crosstab structure to a tabular structure, which means unpivot those relevant value columns by record ID column, then link the unpivot new tabular table via the record ID back to the factor table to align with other rest info such as date, name, and age, etc., which are in the existing reporting slicers. To unpivot factor table, we have two approaches, by Power Query or by DAX expressions. I have made previous video in top suggest highlighted link explained when to use two methods. For our case, as we have the imported data source, the better approach by my view is using Power Query unpivot feature. The approach may slow down data loading speed, but has less effect on the interactive speed with report visuals. By this video, in case for your leads, I shall also show the DAX formula for unpivoting table. Both approaches will generate same result. Okay, let's first try to unpivot the factor table by Power Query. In data view, choose factor table, blood pressure list. Right click to edit query. In Query Editor, on left sidebar, choose the factor table blood pressure list again. Right click, duplicate it, name the duplicated table as BP max min unpivot table by M. Select four columns, systolic BP, diastolic BP, heartbeat, and power APP ID. Right-click on any of these four columns and remove other columns. Select the column Power APP ID. Right-click to unpivot other columns. An expected new tabular table is created, which has only three columns, the record ID, the attribute, and the values. As mentioned before, we shall also find the extremums of associated blood pressure indicator. Thus, for each blood pressure indicator in column value, we need to add additionally column which stores the corresponding associated BP indicator. For creating the additionally column, let's first rename the existing value column as value 1. The DAX expression for creating new column should be as name of column as value 2 with a logic function switch to list out each associated BP value by checking the indicator name in column value 1 and record ID, which is using the Power App ID to look up the associated BP value from factor table, then format the list value to an integer number. Now we have a ready unpivoted table created by Power Query. In case you want the unpivoted table created by DAX expression, you may try the DAX formula shared by me in the screen. Okay, the last step is do not forget to create the necessary relationship from the unpivoted table to the factor table for aligning with other records info, and also create the relationship to the necessary dimension table such as the DIM table BP indicator for later indicator naming conventions and sorting purpose in reporting visualizations. Now with this ready tabular table structure, we can easily to apply DAX expression to create the measures to retrieve the max, mean, average values according to the attribute category column. Our first needed measure will be the measure to find maximum value of associated indicator. The DAX expression should be as name maximum underscore BP underscore DAX. The first variable should find the maximum with max function from column value 1 of the created unpivot table. Variable name should be underscore max underscore value 1. The second variable, name it as underscore max values table, should find a table column to list all possible indicators from column value 2 of the unpivot table, which are associated to the identified value in the first defined variable max value 1. Here we use the functions select columns to list all values in column value 2 from the unpivot table, and apply the calculate table to filter the list by the maximum value in the variable max value 1. The third variable, name it as underscore max underscore value 2, should find the maximum from the list of the second variable, which is the maximum of associated indicator in column value 2. Now we have the max value of the first indicator from column value 1, and the max value of the associated indicator from column value 2. It is the phase now to combine the two variables with a fixed function for converting numbers to text string as the return to the calculated measure maximum underscore BP underscore DAX. As we do not link pulse indicator to BP indicators in our report, thus we use the switch function to combine only the two variables for BP indicator, excluded the compilation for pulse indicator. Let's place the created name measure maximum underscore BP underscore DAX to the prepared matrix visual. We see our expected report data. We may have a quick double check by looking source data table to verify the results. By same way, we can create the measure for minimum underscore BP underscore DAX. For the average measure, name it as AVG underscore BP open bracket unpivot close bracket, which is simply to apply function average to column value 1 of the unpivot table. Place the two measures in the matrix ratio. We see the complete info we expected. That is all about in this short video. You may apply this approach to retrieve the extrema values for more than two associated indicators. Thanks for your watching. If you like to watch more videos from my channel, please subscribe button. See you in next video.